Hello, everybody. Welcome to Managerial Accounting, Cost, Volume, Profit. This is part three, examples of achieving a desired after-tax profit. So over here, we've got YYZ sells inventory for $800 per unit and has variable costs of $550 per unit. Assuming that fixed costs are $622,500, a tax rate of 30%, and a desired after-tax profit of $350, how many units need to be sold to achieve the desired after-tax profit? Prepare a variable costing income statement. Okay. So we're going to do the same thing we did before, except we're going to go ahead and do it with the ratios. We'll do it with the ratios first, then we'll go through and do the statement just to make sure that it works. Okay. So when I'm looking at how many units need to be sold in order to achieve the desired after-tax profit, when I'm dealing with more than fixed costs, right? So right as of right now, and let's just kind of take a look at this. So I've got sales less my variable costs is going to give me my contribution margin, less my fixed costs. And normally this would be zero, but here we're a little bit different because we need an after-tax profit of 350. This is going to give me my net income before income taxes, less income tax expense is going to give me net income after tax. Okay, so if we kind of look at this in terms of as a more of like an elaborate income statement, and let's just start putting in the values that we know as of right now. So here we've got our units per unit and then our total. Okay. So right over here, my per unit, I sell my inventory for $800 per unit. My variable costs are $550 per unit. Okay. My fixed costs are $662,500. And I have a net income after tax that I need to get to of $350,000. So as we're going through and looking at these different numbers, what I'm really trying to do is to go in and to fill in the matrix. Ultimately, what I'm trying to do is we've kind of seen before, I know that my contribution margin is getting my sales price per unit minus my variable cost per unit or $250. So I know that if I can get to this number up here, I'm going to be in pretty good shape. However, the challenge that I have is that this 662 is pre-tax, right? I haven't deducted income taxes from it. And this $350,000 is after tax. So what I'm gonna need to go here and do and solve is what is my net income before income taxes minus that income tax expense and what's gonna get me to that net income after tax. And if we look at the relationships here, if we say that, okay, this is A minus B is C or my contribution margin. If my fixed costs are D, right? C minus D is going to give me my net income before income taxes. If my income tax expense is 30%, when I take E and multiply it by 0.3, we'll call this F. So when I get E minus F equals G. Okay, so as you look at this, this is how this whole formula is going. And this is why it's so important that you put this in an income statement. So let's go ahead and start out down here. If my net income after tax is 350, so we know that my net income after tax is 350, and we have a tax rate of 30%, what is my net income pre-income taxes? What is that gonna be? Well, if I don't know this value, and I'll say I'm going to call this X, right? What's my taxes? Like, what is that going to be? Well, this is going to be minus 0.3X or 30% of that net income before income taxes. So to solve this equation, what I'm now going to do is I'm going to say, well, X minus 0.3 of X equals 350,000. 0.7x is equal to 350,000. X is going to be equal to 350,000 divided by 0.7. So if I take 350,000 divided by 0.7, I'm going to get $500,000. Now, that's how we go through and solve it. Now, let's make sure that this works. If my net income before income taxes is $500,000, that means my income tax expense must have been $150,000 or 30% of that amount. So this is where we're going to be using this very basic type of algebraic math to come up with our results. Now, to get to my contribution margin, now at this point in time, right, I could just go ahead and say, all right, my fixed costs or my basically to my units to achieve the after-tax profit, I could just say 662,500 plus my target pre-tax income is $500,000. This is also known as the target pre-tax income. And if I divide this over here by my contribution margin per unit of 250, right? Where did I get this $250 from? My sales were 800, my variable costs were 550. That means my contribution margin per unit was 250. So this is going to give me 662.5 plus 500,000 divided by 250. And so that the number of units that I would need to go through and sell would be 4,650. So let's go ahead and keep on going. So if I, but the other way I could have also done this too, is I could also say, well, my contribution margin is what? Well, it's going to be 662 plus the 500. Why is that? Because I could do a same thing over here. If I say Y minus 662,500 is equal to 500,000, right? What minus 662 is 500? This is going to be 1,162,000. If I take that 1,162,500 and I divide it over here by 250, I'm going to get to 4,650. So you don't have to go through and do these different ratios. In fact, for something like this, I would actually recommend that you go through and you build the matrix. Now, over here, we've got variable costs, units 4,650 and 4,650. Whatever I have a contribution margin for in units, it means I sold whatever 4,650 in sales. I need 4,650 in terms of units for variable costs. If I go through and multiply these through, I get 3,720,000. I get over here 2,557,500. If I subtract these through, I got 1,162,500, which is my contribution margin. If I subtract the fixed costs of 662, I get to my net income before income taxes, which is my target pre-tax income. Subtracting income tax expense, this is going to give me my net income after tax. So as you can see, going through, we can go through and use these ratios. We're more than empowered to do so. But I'm going to tell you, based on my 8+ years of teaching this, I strongly recommend that you go through and you build the variable costing, contribution margin, income statement. And we build this and we basically go through and put through the units and the like. The other reason why you want to be doing this and getting used to practicing this type of income statement is because when we start looking at absorption versus variable costing, as we start looking at in our next video series, we're going to be going back to this constantly. So the more you can kind of shy yourself away from the ratios and start really building on the financial statements, or the, in this case, the variable costing income statement, the better you're going to be off for learning the material. But in any event, I want to thank you for joining me here today. Please leave any questions that you might have. I really appreciate you liking and subscribing to the channel. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great day.